Now it's Wednesday, back in the stand again up here, and might give this one more night, and then I might hit the other stand. Can really tell the pressure has been really keeping the deer movement down, really depending on the bucks to be in a little bit of a rut so that they can at least get up off their feet and start chasing some does around. But it seems like even when they're on their feet and they're moving around like last night, they are very, very spooky. They're looking at every little thing, and they're not spending much time out in the open. I heard a couple shots around, so people are still shooting and hunting through the week. And so it's just going to be one of those things, putting the time in and as much time as I can. I'm only going to be out here for maybe an hour and a half again, maybe 2 hours and at most, and see if anything comes out. Looks like we got our first deer, and it is, looks like a little button buck, probably from maybe one of the does that we took. All by itself. Wednesday evening, I've heard quite a bit of shooting all around, there's a couple more deer come out in the food plot. They just showed themselves and then went back in. So it's like the deer want to come out to feed, but they're just too cautious. They're just showing themselves for a little bit and going back in. So obviously some pressured deer. Didn't see hardly anything else tonight. So if I get time tomorrow evening, John Nugent, he's coming up. He's taking Friday off, but he's going to try to get up here early Thursday, tomorrow evening. And we may try to set up in the stand here tomorrow evening. If not, I may be out with him Friday, try to get him a doe. Or be over on his property where he might try to shoot a buck. And we'll see how it goes. Okay. I saw the hair fly.
Square.
Like, perfect.
Right behind.
Well, I should be right up here then. Got it. All right. That's a big deer too. you and John just both shot big doe. All right. Well, it's the next day, and I'm going to be driving for some of those guys, Sweeney and John, to see if they can get a buck. So we're going to get in here, get after it, see if we can bump some deer around. Last day. All right, I'm gonna do a little driving through the goldenrod. Sometimes these big bucks like to lay in here. I'm gonna give it a try. So we got John way over there in his deer stand. And we got all this thick bottom to try to push out. We're just gonna do one man, and I'm not hooping and hollering. Some of the best ways to do drives are silent single man drives. And that man has to walk a zigzag to cover a little bit more ground. That's usually the best way to do it. That way you're not having the deer running full sprint. They're just kind of bouncing out in front of you a little bit by little bit because they hear the crunching of the leaves and the goldenrods. That's usually how we do it. Well, I doubt I pushed anything over. Whew. No shots. Huh? I didn't see nothing, but I saw a pile of sign down there. Buck grub, scrapes, beds, trails.
We've known forever, but down there's a gold mine.
And there's really no other good place that you could put it where
we have it.
You see a lot of stuff, because it is just thick, nasty down in there.
Yeah, in my personal opinion, I think we have the bowl here as best covered as we can. With my stand looking down both sides, Craig up there looking down the line, and Luke's down here in this bottom, looking down into the woods this way and then up the gas line.
But, yeah.
You know, most of the time Craig hasn't been in his stand lately, but he's out of state. It's hard for him to come in.
Well, we'll go down and see if Sweeney locked up and got buck fever and couldn't pull the trigger.
Eat a family of four.
More meat to feed than you could feed a family of four.
No, I have enough meat to feed a family of four. But it's only a family of me. So you know what one of those hindquarters is getting made into? Deer sticks.
Yeah.
See where he says. The amount of deer he shot, feeds a family of four. I shot the same amount of deer, me and Ashley might make it till next year.
I don't know. We do a lot of
strong.
We do a lot of cooking for like our friend groups and stuff. Like you do those deer stuffed shells down at the lake. Yeah. Those are impeccable.
Those are fine.
I make deer burgers. We go on this lake trip with a bunch of our friends from school, and we cook a lot of deer meat down there. It's actually pretty funny, and they've all just become accustomed to it.
Erica does the biscuits and
The biscuits and deer sausage gravy. Whoa. That's another one.
Everybody's getting hungry watching this right now.
You know what? You got a couple of chefs just walking through the fields.
Listen, I don't claim to be a chef. That oven contraption, no. Give me a grill. I'll stir some stuff up.
And they're done with rifle season. They're heading back. They got half a truck bed, no bucks this year, but
yeah.
Got meat in the freezer. I mean,
but the bed's smaller, so it looks like a fuller bed.
Yeah.
A fuller bed this year.
All right, we'll see you guys.
See you, Roar.
Later, John.
Last few hours of the season remaining. Nugent and Sweeney headed home. I'm going to basically take the 243 for a walk and see what I see. Well, it looks like we got rain coming. Checking my trail cameras. These are just Browning trail cameras and stuff like that. That no flash or anything like that. But looks like I got some doe coming down through here. Big black bear. Looks like it's after when Luke Nugent and I saw the bear with the three cubs. This looks like there's a single big one. Because Luke, about a mile and a half away, about 2 miles away, saw a big single black bear, which is odd because normally we don't see a lot of black bear during rifle season here. This is just a little bit of a highway right below the trees because the deer shanty's right through here. Trail camera right here watching up and down, see what's coming through. I got another trail camera on the road up here, so we're going to go check that one. And if it keeps raining, I'm going to get the deer shanty, but it's not that bad right now. Well, I saw one buck. Guys are shooting like crazy about a couple miles from here. I think everybody's last light, meat in the freezer, shooting doe. I think I just jumped a little buck. I couldn't tell if it was a legal buck or not, but I'm assuming I saw antlers. But without any snow, it's still sprinkling, but not enough to where I can sneak yet. Leaves are still crunchy. But right now, I don't hear it raining, so it's on and off. So I got about a 2 mile walk back to the truck, and I'm going to sneak my way back, and then that's the end of my rifle season. Well, that just goes to show you, could have filled my tag on that same buck that I saw on, I don't know what day it was. It was during the first week. So he's been out here running around the whole time. I just saw he was chasing a doe along the hillside. Two smaller bucks ran down and come out onto the road in front of me. And I looked up and there was that bigger buck chasing a doe. So they're still rutting, they're still chasing doe. And you can still hear the shooting behind me. And, but you know, that deer is gonna get himself killed by chasing a doe. You know, it just goes to show you, you can still kill nice buck on the last day. So I could have shot him, that's two times. And you know, everyone that was saying from the first video, like, you should never let that deer go, he'll get shot by somebody else. Why would you let a deer like that go? Well, that's proof right there. Just because you let him go doesn't mean he's gonna get shot. Now, we still have, what, 2 hours left? 2.5 hours of left of hunting? Can he still get shot? Yeah. The chances are, I don't know. It's just not good because he's been out for the past week and a half and is still alive. And so the chances of him making another 2 hours are high. He can still get shot by somebody, but that's just the way it goes. So always, that was a big boom. That was not a gun. That was like Tannerite that just went off. And I hear some turkeys yelping back here behind me, but that was really weird. Okay, I am going to, because he kind of bumped up over the hill with that doe, I'm gonna circle back around, see if I can see him again, and if not, then I still got a long walk back to the truck. It's raining pretty good, and this shooting has not stopped. I can see for a long ways. Wait, do I see a hunter over there? Yes, I do. Well, looks like everybody's doing what I'm doing. You're either shooting at a deer or you're gonna go get cover, because it looks like this next rain isn't gonna be stopping. So I'll probably get up in the deer shanty and just sit out the rest of my deer season in there. It seems like everywhere I look, everybody's on top of the hillsides waiting for guys to push deer, maybe doing some deer drive. They're really giving it a last shot here, last day, last couple hours, so. Well, coming out just to get in the deer shanty, and we got a couple doe standing out. That looks like another big doe. Yeah, she ain't gonna hang out too long. I was getting ready to get in the deer shanty, but now that I bumped them, I think I'll just go to the lower shanty and sit for a little bit. Now this is why I got a deer shanty. It is coming down pretty good. Everything's getting wet. And you know, I like to film my deer hunting, and I can't film when the camera's getting wet. I just can't. So that's one thing that I can do now that I never could do. It's film deer hunting in the rain, because I think the last time I did it, I had a little blind and brought the buddy heater and just sat in there. Well, you're on the ground and you can't see hardly anything at all anyways. So I'm gonna sit here for the remainder, and I'm having a feeling last light, finally the shooting stopped when the rain came. I think this is gonna be pretty much it for my rifle season. Whether I go into flintlock season, it's hard to say this year because it's got a lot going on. So hope you guys enjoyed this video, and see you next year.